The appropriate process is suspension, and then once the investigation has been done, if it turns out that there is no clear association, then the immunisation can be resumed. What happened last week was exactly as it should have been. The procedures adopted, as far as I can tell, were correct.
People before profit say the Residential Tenancies Bill abandons renters. It's due before the Dáil later today. It aims to extend protections for renters who have lost income due to the pandemic. But TD Richard Boyd Barrett says it removes protection for others.
So under the guise of extending some protections for some tenants, in fact, what they're doing is opening the door and in the green light to wholesale evictions for tenants in the midst of a pandemic as soon as the level 5 restrictions are lifted. It's a disgraceful abandonment of tenants who need and deserve protection.
FM 104. 13 puppies were rescued after they were found in two cages at Dublin Port over the weekend. The DSPCA says its inspectors were called after customs found the dogs hidden behind the seats of a car. The charity says all of the puppies are now on medication and will remain in their care until they are well enough for adoption. It says there was not enough of a second thought given to the welfare of these puppies, just the joy of the profit to be made by their sale. A senator from Dublin West says the zoo could operate safely if it was allowed to reopen. Ian McCurry says many parks are under severe pressure, with more people heading to them as the weather improves. She says reopening Dublin Zoo with strict controls in place would help ease that pressure. We asked the senator if she had concerns that doing this would encourage people to break their 5K.
That's probably the biggest issue around it. And I do think that people have to operate within their travel restrictions. We can ask the public to do that, but also I wonder if the zoo could consider some sort of, as part of the pre-booking system, to ask that question or get people to confirm where they're coming from. That's something that I think the zoo would have to consider as part of their pre-booking.
Now streaming on Disney Plus, an all-new 6-part original series. After Avengers Endgame changed everything, a new adventure begins.
Here we go again, huh?
Join Falcon and the Winter Soldier.
Superheroes cannot be allowed to exist.
Oh, yeah!
In the exciting new chapter of the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
That wasn't so hard.
Falcon and the Winter Soldier, a 6-part original series now streaming only on Disney Plus. Only for subscription requirements and Spotify.
FM104sports.com.
Don't let a new smashed phone or tablet smash your wallet. Protect your new gadgets at GadgetInsurance.com.
On Republic of Ireland, Captain James.
Somewhere I was going, that's all. That was enough for him.
In the first qualifier for the 2022 finals in Qatar, manager Stephen Kenny has enjoyed a luckless start since replacing McCarthy last year. He's yet to register and his team has scored just one goal in 8 games. And despite their preparations being hit with a spate of injuries, Captain James Coleman says they are determined.
I left you a message on your phone.
What?
I left you a message on your phone.
Yeah. The campaign is, you know, they're short, and then you go back and you play at club level, and I think a lot of the time you're bringing your club foreign confidence into international football. Like, you're not so much thinking of how we did last time with Ireland. So there'll be lads coming in here eager to be well, eager to impress, and then I'm always confident when we play for Ireland, and we'll do the same tomorrow night.
Kickoff is at 7:45 with Ireland's Group A rivals Portugal taking on Azerbaijan at the same time. Wales also begins the qualification campaign with a daunting trip to the world's number one ranked team, Belgium. They've only reached the World Cup finals on one previous occasion way back in 1958. And then golf, Rory McIlroy, Shane Lowry both begin their WGC Dell Match Play Championship campaigns today in Texas. McIlroy gets underway in San Diego against Ian Poulter. Larry's first game in Group 3 is against Ryan Palmer, and it's the first of a possible 7 matches that they would have to play in order to win the tournament. That's FM104 Sport with GadgetInsurance.com. Don't wait until you from the comes to Rob. Do the smart thing now by insuring it at GadgetInsurance.com.
Left your message on your phone.
Still here for a
Like boiler
replacement. The phone is off at the moment, charges. It was running out of battery overnight. Will increase
this afternoon. But it won't get shot for one single
moment. Tell me.
Thank you. see this new story.
Yeah, I've seen that. Your man went, his hand was shaking, and the tumor started, yeah.
Yeah. He worked with the black art. The great knight.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, good shirt. Very bad news, very bad news.
He worked with Jack O'Reilly and he said that he was at one of his races.
Yeah.
The photograph of him and Jack O'Reilly and I, do you remember?
Yeah, I remember, yeah.
It's Liam! Liam! I'm in the middle of talking to you and you go and slam the door. I think that's quite rude if you don't mind me saying.
I'm in the bathroom.
I know, there's no need to close the door and talk to you.
What are you saying?
I said he worked with Jack O'Reilly tonight, he was at one of his races. So there's a photograph of him beside Jack O'Reilly tonight.
Yeah.
You go into the bathroom, close the door, and I'm in the middle of talking, saying something to you.
Yeah, decorating
night, yeah. There's a photograph of him at one of, I think it was his final race.
Yeah.
Photograph of him beside Jack O'Reilly tonight.
Yeah.
He said, do you remember that photograph,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, right, yeah.
I won't have a shower, okay, I'll just go. I'm not getting a
cobbler
off. Yeah, here. I'm just rude, girl. I'm not going to say something. I'm not going to say something.
Looking fine. life you can run, you're not quite conscious. Baby, why you wanna diss me like you don't need me? Like I don't mock you and you still try to reach me. How you figure out how to comment from the TV? You running out of chances and it's not on me.
And you thought it was the wrong spot, but actually, you realised the walk home was quicker from where you got off that time. A beautiful little mistake. Do you know what I'm saying? Maybe once you took a wrong turn and you found the most gorgeous deli and you went to a deli that you normally wouldn't be going to, this day you still go to that deli. Maybe at the deli one day, the person behind the counter misheard you and put cheese in your water with your coleslaw, and before that you'd never given it a go, and now you're like, oh, that was such a great mistake. You know what I'm saying? The best mistake you've ever made. Maybe you grabbed someone's taxi when you shouldn't have, and that just started a conversation with two people and you've gone out with them. 087-679-7777.